Honey, allow me to be your sign that you have been asking for and been needing to let go of that situation that has been doing nothing but causing you stress and anxiety, honey. It is not worth it for it to be living in your mind rent-free and you're not being paid for it, honey. Hey, girl.
Hello, my beautiful Taurus. How are you doing? My name is Simply Valka, and today I'm going to be doing your weekly bonus tarot reading. So if you enjoy this reading and you find some cards that resonate with you in this bonus reading for you, Taurus, today, I would really appreciate it if you were to give this video a like and subscribe. Also, let me know which cards resonate with you and how the tarot cards resonate with you, because that's how I keep up with you, is through the comments, Taurus. As well, I just want to remind you before we get into this reading to use your intuition. You know your situation best. Remember, I'm just a man reading some tarot cards to you. I'm just trying to give you some food for thought, a perspective to consider with these tarot cards. So I'll let you make the decision in your life because you know your life best, right? So let's now just get into your, these cards are not even remotely close to being straight. I guess that kind of reflects my energy then a little bit, huh? Doesn't it, honey? Anyways, let's get into your weekly bonus reading, Taurus.
Oh, my beautiful Taurus. So as you saw from the cards before, right, I already pulled them for you, but I still want to break them down into sections, right? Because I like to view tarot as like a puzzle, Taurus. So we have for you the King of Pentacles, the Four of Swords, the Star card, and then the Three of Swords. So how I'm breaking this storyline down, Taurus, is that I see for some of you guys, you guys actually shot your shot with something. You guys were in this process of going after something that you really wanted for pretty badly. I say this because of the Star card, right? The Star card is that card of wish fulfillment, Taurus. And so, and it's also the card of like just kind of how you imagine a star, Taurus. Like, it seems like sometimes they're like so close yet so far away. One of those things that you could just never quite reach. Right? And probably is whatever the situation is, whether it's like pursuing a person, Taurus, or whether it's just like a, it just feels like we're honing in on a situation of where you tried something and, you know, you really were giving it your all, your full heart. And then we have the Three of Swords here, where you have pain attached to it. Now, for this Taurus, it kind of like has me like tilting my head and being like, well, what happened here, right? I do see you guys not really getting stuck in this rut because of this little bit of a bump in the road, we'll call it, Taurus. So I really am happy for you in that regard. But yeah, I guess it does just suck that you kind of were left disappointed with something, right? I know you guys are not sitting in this energy for too long, Taurus, because Four of Swords comes in like right after the fact, right? The Four of Swords is that card of allowing the situation to teach you whatever it needs to teach you, and to oddly enough, it's almost like through this pain that you experienced, you're healing something else. I kind of feel, Taurus, it does kind of feel like just because of how this is all like roped together, I don't know, it just is almost like this weird thing, like through this disappointment, you healed maybe something completely even different. Or, I mean, maybe I could just be trying to be extremely optimistic, Taurus, admittedly, right? It could just be you just healing from this process. But you are still striving towards the King of Coins or the King of Pentacles, right? You're still striving for this stability, even though this didn't work out, right? You're not letting this dissuade you, or it's not wavering your faith in some regard. Like, you're still like that hopeless romantic, Taurus. You still kind of feel like at some point you still have hope for reaching the star, right? And that whatever that star is for you, I do see that it brings forth, like, since the focus point with your other cards, Taurus, is a lot of pentacles, a lot of your energy, earth energy, Taurus. I do kind of get the assumption that I can't help but feel like it's just more so like your it's kind of like roped into like your home life, or just something that would be part of your consistent everyday. Does that make sense? That would just bring forth like some nice sense of security, if that makes sense, Taurus. And then getting into your second row of cards of kind of like the what is to come, like what is the I like to view this as Taurus, kind of like what is it you can hope for from this, right? And so you have the Page of Pentacles, the Ace of Pentacles, the Five of Cups, and then the Hanged Man. So Taurus, like, this is what I was saying, like, it's almost like through the, this disappointment that you're experiencing with this Five of Cups here, because I do kind of feel like it's attached to the situation. Dare I say, especially with this dynamic, again, I don't know what it is with me, Taurus, and saying dare I say in only my tarot readings, but it does feel as if, like, this has been like a repeated thing, because here's the thing, like with this Five of Cups, like you're still looking back on the situation and just being like, even though it disappointed you and just what have you, it's kind of like, it feels like each through these cups, like you gave this thing like three different chances and each time it kept spilling the cups over. It's kind of how I'm seeing it, because normally, excuse me, Taurus, I feel like I'm losing my voice. But normally, if it was just like a one-time thing, then I would see like the Six of Swords, Taurus, probably, where you're just transitioning. But with this, this is kind of like one of those situations where it's like, it was very hard for you to finally detach from it. And that's probably what it's healing for you, Taurus, is where it's like, it took you so long to detach from the situation because I feel like you experienced like the repetitiveness of the pain, right? Actually, now that I'm like, realizing in this message, Taurus, you have the three spilled cups here and the three swords here, right? So it's like, again, like this emphasis on threes of where I just kind of see this as like repeated attempts. I also just want to say full bias, Taurus, just disclaimer, right? I'm going to suggest to you to write down the number three just because how this is turning out, but three is also my favorite number, so I could very well just be telling you that just because nothing intuitive, Taurus, and just the fact that it's my favorite number, but maybe there'll be a message in that that resonates. Yeah, and also the emphasis here, like I wanted to point this out in the star card, I forgot to, but you notice this individual is balancing cups, right? Balancing liquids, and that's still like the representation of emotions, right? And associated with this as well. Just one of those small details, Taurus, I like to point out. And this Hanged Man comes in after the fact, where you get like this different perspective. This is where, again, this healing kind of came into place, right? So this is, yeah, I can't help but feel like this pain was almost like a necessity for you, Taurus. And normally I'm kind of self-conscious and just like how corny it sounds, and probably how overused it is in the spiritual community, of where it's just like, oh, let's just find purpose in that pain. It's just like, okay, honey, like, just because you can find a purpose in that pain doesn't mean you want to A, experience it again, and 2, B, it still can sometimes feel unbearable, right? But I see for you this kind of like this last disappointment, this last straw that broke the camel's back, or the feather that broke the camel's back, Taurus, for you. It finally broke this like obsession that you had with this situation. And then you have the Ace of Pentacles with the Page of Pentacles, which is powerful, right? I get this sense here of Taurus for you of almost like after this, the disappointment with the situation and you transitioning on, moving on, right? You looking into the other direction, noticing those two other cups that are filled, and seeing things differently. It's almost just like you're like just appreciating what you currently have in your space more. But also, I do just get this. I'll just explain like how you would see this in tarot, Taurus, and you can take the message as you will. But you know, with the Page of Pentacles, this is like someone extending their pentacle out to you. So you may be developing closer connections with people. I kind of get the sense, though, if this is connected to like a person, Taurus, I do get the sense that It's almost like you're going to be like bonding and getting closer with someone that's already in your space. It's just like, that's just straight up just intuitive here. So maybe you have like a friend or a person that you've known, talked to a little bit here and there, but maybe there's like some distance for a while. Now that you are done and you're done with this old situation, you're able to like get back to and appreciate like the healthy things in your life and the healthy people. But with this Ace of Pentacles here, I can't also neglect from, again, like an opportunity way that in terms of finances, Taurus, as well. Overall, it just feels like a really good opportunity is being presented to you, whether it's through an actual person or whether it's through spirit offering that pentacle. There's definitely a prize being presented to you, or a reward or a gift of some sort being presented to you in some way. Like something is heading towards you. Taurus, this pentacle is heading towards you. I just can't quite tell, obviously, through a general reading what it would be, because this reading is meant for thousands of Tauruses, right? It's going to come in different shapes. But the very least I can say, Taurus, is that pain you experience, it's corny, I know, but I feel like now that you're able to close this chapter off, something really, really delightful that's going to bring forth this abundance or the stability that you've been craving, it's heading towards you. Like stuff that's like, I don't know, you get the point, Taurus. So I'm not going to go on, can babble on with this anymore, but I hope this tarot reading resonated with you, Taurus. Thank you so much for allowing me to do this reading for you. If you enjoyed this, be sure to give this video a like and subscribe, and let me know in the comments which card resonated the most with you, Taurus. Also, I do your weekly zodiac readings, Taurus, that every single week, which I'll leave a link to somewhere around here for you to check out. And yeah, hopefully I can connect with you sometime in the near future, Taurus. I love you so much.